So here's a picture of our governor, the state of Colorado's governor. Put it here. All right, it's John Hinkenlooper, okay? So take a look at him, right? Oh, he's got that down home boyish charm, right? Got that sort of countrified boyish charm. He's got that, he's all parted up, right? And smiling. Hey, everybody. Hi, I'm a good man. I'm a good guy. Yeah, okay, but you showed you're a wimp. You showed that you're a coward when it comes to Donald Trump's administration. And the level you submit to is the level of injustice that'll be perpetuated upon you. And John Hinkenlooper isn't even local. He was born in Pennsylvania. He's born in Pennsylvania. So how did this outsider, how did this conquistador come into this state and take over? They got them pretty baby blues, right? So he's literally a blue-eyed devil. And he was actually born one day before me, 30 years before me. So February 7th, 1952. That would make him an Aquarius, which doesn't mean anything, but he was born in the spring, which that could mean something. But what's up with that smile there, John? Hey, John, what's up with that smile? It looks like you're trying to smile or you're like not really happy. It's like it's a cheesy fake smile. I like the people. I like the people of Colorado. So many Democratic and Republican lawmakers wanted to legalize marijuana pot clubs in Colorado for the entire state of Colorado, but the governor, the Democratic governor, John Hinkenlooper, threatened to veto it. He threatened to veto it. He says, if you assholes try to pass this, I will stop you. I will stop you just like how Jeff Sessions will stop you. And he's trying to couch it saying that, you know, he's just doesn't want to provoke, right, Jeff Sessions and all that. Marijuana's already legalized. He's already been provoked. So we need to take this as far as we can take it and then let them scale it back. But if we're going to start scaling it back on our own, well, hell, you're just allowing them to, you know, run roughshod over you. You can stand up and you could fight and you may lose, but if you don't fight, you've lost already. So here's an article by the Associated Press, came out a couple weeks ago. It said that it's the starkest display yet of legal pot states' uncertainty of how to regulate the drug under Donald Trump. Alaska marijuana regulators recently delayed planned rules for on-site pot consumption at dispensaries. Right now, the states where you can go ahead and smoke a joint and not get arrested is Alaska, California, Colorado, Maine, Massachusetts, Nevada, Oregon, and Washington. Those are the eight states. So we have eight states where you can get medical marijuana and recreation. So recreational marijuana, that's the goal, and the District of Columbia. So we got the District of Columbia, right, the nation's capital, plus eight U.S. states. So remember that. Remember it. You got four here on the West Coast, right? Colorado in the, you know, Midwest. And then you have Maine and Massachusetts over in the East and Alaska. So Maine, Massachusetts, Alaska, Colorado, Washington, Oregon, Nevada, California. These are the cool states. These are the states that freak Jeff Sessions right the fuck out. So the reason that John Hinkenlooper, the governor, John Hinkenlooper, did not want to approve pot clubs, right? You can go to the store, you can buy it, but you got to consume it in your home. There's no place for potheads to get together. There's no bars for marijuana users. And so the reason why John Hinkenlooper went ahead and backed off this, even though it had bipartisan, substantial bipartisan support. Republicans and Democrats, they were all in favor of having pot clubs. But the Democratic governor, John Hinkenlooper, he says that he was afraid of what Trump is going to do since it's still illegal, right? It's a Schedule II narcotic under the Trump administration. He's got Jeff Sessions, and Jeff Sessions is sitting there saying that marijuana is going to, you know, make you crazy. You're going to have horns growing out of your heads, and you're just going to turn into, you know, a heroin addict, apparently. So Jeff Sessions is going on this witch hunt against marijuana users. Now, Donald Trump in 1990 had actually said that he was in favor of legalizing everything, decriminalizing all drugs. including marijuana. Now he's completely backed off of marijuana. So this is terrifying. This is bad. If the governor is going to go ahead and back off, that means they're backing away from any kind of fight. That means you already lost. You already lost. Go ahead and get pot clubs and then see if the federal government comes in here and fucks with the people's referendum. The people of Colorado have spoken. The people of Colorado has decided this. So for anybody, any president, right, it's dependent upon the consent of the governed. So for any politician who needs to get votes, I don't think going against the will of the people is such a hot idea. That's not a good idea. The level that you submit to is the level of injustice that will be perpetuated upon you. So John Hinkenlooper showed a embarrassing non-courage. What's the a cowardice, okay? John Hinkenlooper was very much a proud coward. He stood up and said loudly, even though everybody in the House of Representatives and the Senate, right, bipartisan support, not everybody, but a substantial amount of people, he was like, nah, I don't give a shit. I don't care if the people are in favor of it. I don't care if the legislators are in favor of it. I'm the king. I'm the dictator. And fuck marijuana pot clubs. Well, that's bullshit, man. That's bullshit. Because pot clubs, that's going to be the Soviets. That's going to be the beer halls. That's going to be the place for politics. That will be where you'll have a lot of organized cliques organizing themselves and talking about politics. Maybe that's the reason John Hinkenlooper doesn't want to have these pot clubs. Given the uncertainty in Washington, this is not the time to be trying to carve off new turf and expand markets and make dramatic statements about marijuana, John Hinkenlooper told the Denver Post last month. Colorado already has 30 private pot clubs. There's already 30 private pot clubs in existence. So under what law? They're in no man's law now. No man's territory. Marijuana is legal here. And if a bunch of adults want to get together in a private club, why can't they smoke marijuana? How can you even regulate something like that unless you just are too loud about it? But you have to meet up in secret, right? I mean, it's legal. We're allowed to smoke pot. Pot is legal now. It says sometimes that these private pot clubs have been raided by law enforcement and they operate under different local regulations. So they're kind of in no man's land right now. So I believe that marijuana is the vanguard issue for the next generation. This is our last generation. I mean, this is how many more frontiers are there, right? Get gay people, get their freedom, allow potheads to be allowed, you know, to smoke, legalize marijuana. This is the last thing, and we got to protect it. We have a right to our own bodies. We're Americans. We should be Americans. Nixon started this goddamn war on drugs, just like he started the EPA, right? But apparently Trump is to the right of Richard Nixon. But when it comes to the war on drugs, they're throwing people in jail for like 70 to 100 years just for marijuana in the 70s. 100 years? Yeah, good job, 60s. Good job, hippies. Y'all went back to the establishment, didn't you? You're like, oh, freedom, love, peace. Shit. I need to go get a job at Walmart. Why not unionize that place? Why not, you know, establish your own local government-owned Walmart? Dirty fucking hippies were right. They just didn't have the power to, you know, they didn't read the rules for radicals. They didn't get into positions of authority and power and change this country the way it should have been changed. So John Hinkenlooper is very much a coward. He is totally wimping out. He is such a wimp. And this is the Democrats. Why don't Democrats have any balls? Why can't they stand up? Stand up and take your licks. Stand up and say, this is what I believe in. Okay? And having the right to your own body, right? You don't have to decriminalize everything. I believe everything should be decriminalized. But marijuana? That's how the younger generation should know that the older generation has been lying to the entire fucking time. Marijuana is a Schedule II narcotic. You think marijuana is like heroin and cocaine? Fuck you. What else you been lying about, you sons of bitches? Marijuana is not a gateway drug to other drugs. Marijuana is a gateway to get through your all's bullshit, you older baby boomer generation. You motherfuckers are sitting there trying to tell me this is heroin. No, alcohol is actually way worse than marijuana, but you dumb motherfuckers are going to sit there and try to tell me that alcohol should be legal, but marijuana, which is medicine too, and there's the hemp argument, but you're gonna what? Marijuana that comes, you're gonna grow out big donkey ears and you're gonna grow out horns and you're gonna be all crazed and just, you know, all potted out on weed and you're gonna go steal stupid shit from people's houses, vases and whatnot just to appease your addiction? Fuck you. That's such bullshit. You guys are lying. You're hungry, happy, sleepy. Hungry, happy, sleepy. Those are the side effects. That's it. Then California and Maine, there were ballot measures that were approved that allowed pot clubs. The city of Denver even passed a pot club bill too, or a measure that was approved by the voters. So Denver themselves, you know, they're allowed to have pot clubs. I think this is the obvious next step, and good. Now potheads are going to get organized, and now we're going to take over. We're going to show the hippies how, you know, how we do things, how the millennials do things. The hippies failed, Generation X failed. Is Generation Y, the millennials, are we going to fail? I don't fucking think so. I'm going to keep fighting till I'm dead. I don't know about you. You must resist. You must stand up. If you don't, then you're just going to allow the federal government to run roughshod over you. Your hesitation, your blinking. Because you blinked, the federal government knows now that you're not going to do shit when they come raid your pot stores. When they come raid the pot stores, the state should prevent the federal government from doing that shit. The sheriffs in the county, the government, the power of the government comes from the people. I believe that it's the sheriffs controls the county, right? And then the states control the state. And the federal government only has limited jurisdiction in different areas. Interstate commerce and, you know, other shit. They don't just get to come in and do as the fuck as they please. No, I don't think so. The state's got certain laws. You gotta abide by the state's laws. So if the feds want to come in and start raiding people and arresting people, well, the sheriff can arrest them, and they should, because they're coming in using violence, they're attacking people, they're stealing property, and then they're falsely imprisoning them. This is official misconduct, so there's plenty of charges right there. There's 5 charges I just mentioned that any local Colorado city or state police officer could go after the feds if they tried to fuck with the marijuana laws, if they tried to fuck with the retail shops or people using in the privacy of their own homes or even pot clubs. John Hinkenlooper used to be a geologist, so he understands the world, he understands the earth. He also entered a career in business and co-founded the Wincoop Brewing Company in Denver. So this motherfucker thinks it's okay to go ahead and sell alcohol to the masses, encourage alcoholism, encourage DUIs and drunkenness. That shit's acceptable, right? You got bars everywhere, you got advertisements all over the place. My God, you cannot, there's probably not a drug that's more pushed in people's faces than alcohol. So he's a big alcohol man, right? But when it comes to marijuana, he's going to say no, there's going to be restrictions. I'm not ready for restrictions yet. I am nervous that it could be reversed. It could be reversed. Look at Jeff Sessions. My God, that's embarrassing, okay? Colorado, we're ahead of the curve. Let's stay ahead of the curve. It turns out that John Hinkenlooper is actually term limited from running again. He's already been in there for 2 terms. So the election for governor is coming up this next November. So a lot of people are already jumping in right now and declaring, you know, themselves a candidate. So he's not a lame duck, but he's getting closer to lame duck status. I'm not for sure if the state of Colorado is still in session. I mean, it's the end of April. I mean, 2 weeks ago, right, they had that the club bill, marijuana club bill was knocked down. So I'm not for sure if they're still passing laws right now or not. And if they're not, then that means there's only going to be 1 more session next year. And then that'll be it for John Hinkenlooper. So who is out there that is worthy to be Colorado's next governor? So I'm looking at this Wikipedia, you know, thing online here. And it only names Democrats and Republicans. The people of Colorado had actually voted for independents. Independents, there's open primaries, and now independents are allowed to vote in the primary campaigns. I think it's for presidential elections, but I also think that there's 2 of them. So there was 1 for the presidential election, and I think the rest of them was just for anybody. In any primary, anybody could just jump in and vote for someone's primary. So the people that had declared their candidacy for the Democrats, because that's the only party that's going to matter to me, and then once the Republicans pick theirs, you know, I'll make fun of the Republicans, what have you, right? There's this actually Eric Underwood. He's a businessman. He was a Republican candidate for GA-10 in 2007 and a Republican candidate for U.S. Senate in 2016. So Eric Underwood. Who you trying to fool, man? Who you trying to kid? Eric Underwood is a Republican through and through, but he's running as a Democrat. I don't understand why. Ed Perlmutter, Kerry Kennedy, Mike Johnson, and Noel Ginsburg are the five Democrats who have announced their candidacy. So I'm going to be quoting them. I mean, they're going to get some publicity from me, and then I'm going to have a playlist so that way you can see, you know, all the videos that I make about Colorado's gubernatorial election in 2018. This is an issue that Democrats should not drop the ball on. There are Republicans out there. There was Ron Paul, not Rand. Rand had actually made this college woman pray to an aqua Buddha. I don't know what happened. It's an allegation, but there's one, you know, anonymous report out there that the candidate he was running against for Senate thought it significant enough to point out. But the rumor was that he kidnapped this female, this woman, and took her down by the creek and then made her pray to an aqua Buddha. And that was some sort of marijuana initiation thing. And since then, he has completely backed away. Rand Paul, the, you know, little mini-me, Ron Paul's mini-me. So Ron Paul's mini-me isn't big into marijuana, but Ron Paul himself is, right? Libertarian, you have the right to your own body. And Sarah Palin. Sarah Palin is in favor of the legalization of marijuana. So this Ed Perlmutter, he seems like he could be a better candidate when it comes to protecting the legalization of marijuana. Ed Perlmutter introduced H.R. 2076, the Marijuana Business Access to Banking Act of 2015, into the U.S. House of Representatives on April 28, 2015. The bill's goal was to create protections for depository institutions that provide financial services to marijuana-related businesses, and is co-sponsored by Denny Heck and 13 other Republican and Democratic representatives. So that's good, right? If you're helping the retail market out, fuck the federal, man. This is such bullshit. It's not a Schedule II fucking narcotic. It's not a goddamn narcotic. The police in Kentucky want to be like, it's a narcotic. What are you doing with this narcotic? Really? You think that's a narcotic? Are you fucking stupid? How fucking stupid are you? It's not a fucking narcotic, you dumb motherfuckers.